Hi everyone! Welcome to Libraryland! It's beautiful weather outside. I'm in a good mood. Spring is here. So let's start our song. You can follow it with the pictures and do it along with me, okay? Spring is here, spring is here. How do you think I know? I see a bluebird. That is how I know. Spring is here, spring is here. How do you think I know? I see the flowers, that is how I know. Spring is here, spring is here, how do you think I know? I see a bunny, that is how I know. Spring is here, spring is here, how do you think I know? I see a rainbow, that is how I know. Spring is here, how do you think I know? I see the blue sky, that is how I know. Spring is here, how do you think I know? I feel the sunshine, that is how I know. Good job, everybody! Go sit down, relax, and let me tell you the story of the caterpillar and the pollywog. And it is written by Jack Kent. Okay. Let me turn the page. The caterpillar and the pollywog. There we go. Caterpillars aren't like other folks. As ducks and hippopotamuses and you and I get older, especially hippopotamuses, they grow bigger and bigger. But not caterpillars. They turn into beautiful butterflies. Turning into something else like that is not a thing that just anybody can do. Down by the pond, there lived a caterpillar who was very proud of being different. She bragged about it. Oh, she bragged about it to her friends. When I grow up, I'm going to turn into something else, she told the snail. That's nice, said the snail, who really didn't care any way or the other. When I grow up, I'm gonna turn into something else, she told the turtle. I don't blame you, said the turtle, who didn't much like wiggly things. Oh, look at that face. Grow up, I'm going to turn into something else, she told the pollywog. Oh, what fun, said the pollywog. What are you going to turn into? But the caterpillar hurried on her way, looking for someone else to tell her secret to. I wish I could turn into something else too when I grow up, said the pollywog. You will, said the fish. All pollywogs do. What am I going to turn into? The pollywog asked. But the fish saw a tasty bug and dashed after it. Yum, 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 yum. When I grow up, said the caterpillar, who had circled the pond and was going around for the second time. When I grow up, she told the pollywog again, I'm going to turn into something else. So am I, said the pollywog. You? The caterpillar was so surprised, she almost fell into the pond. The fish said so, the pollywog told her. Fish knows things, you know. They go to school. The caterpillar was upset. I thought only caterpillars could do it, she said rather sadly. What are we going to turn into? The pollywog asked. Well, I am going to turn into a butterfly, said the caterpillar. Then I guess I will turn too in a butterfly, said the pollywog. What fun. Let's do it together. All right, the caterpillar agreed, although she would rather have done it alone. But I get to get first. The pollywog didn't mind. He wasn't at all sure how it was done. I'll watch you, he said. So, when the time came, the caterpillar started to spin a cocoon. This is the tricky part, she said. The pollywog watched as the caterpillar spun, and soon only her head was uncovered. Now I have to close the lid, she said, and when I come out, I'll be a butterfly. Oh, go ahead, the pollywog said excitedly. I want to see you do it. It will take a while, the caterpillar warned. She started spinning again and was soon out of sight in the cocoon. But what is happening with the pollywog? For a long time, nothing happened. But the pollywog was patient. He watched and watched and watched for days and days and days. And at last, there was activity in the cocoon. The end of it opened, and very slowly, the caterpillar climbed out. Only, she wasn't a caterpillar anymore. She was a butterfly, a beautiful yellow butterfly. The pollywog was so excited, he hopped up and down in delight. He hopped up and down like a frog. I was so busy watching you, he said, I didn't notice what was happening to me. You are a very handsome frog, the butterfly said, as she flew off to try her new wings. But the frog was puzzled. I thought I was going to be a butterfly, he said. A caterpillar wiggled by. When I grow up, she said proudly to the frog, I'm going to turn into something else. But the frog, he wasn't listening. He was admiring his reflection in the water. I am, you know, a very handsome frog, he said. And that is the end. So let's put the book away and let me show you our activity for today. It's an easy one. You can do it probably at home too when you have a balloon. So first we blow up the balloon. Help me blow. It's hard work. Good job. Thank you. Now we put a nut in it. Okay, there he goes. And here up front, I cut out a little pond with little froggies. Look, let's see if we can let them jump. So now first you have to wrap your balloon. Wrap, 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 wrap. Oh, in your pants, on your shirt, on your sweater. It doesn't matter. Wrap, 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 wrap. Get your little froggies and see if they can jump. Ah, there they go. There they go. Ah, good job, froggy. There you are. Good job. And when they don't jump anymore, you just start rubbing the balloon again. And then try again and again and again. And perhaps with different animals too. Who knows? So, let's end this story time with five green and speckled frogs. So give me five fingers. That are your five froggies. Your arm is the log. Five green and speckled frogs, sitting on a speckled log, eating the most delicious bugs. Yum, yum. One jumped into the pool, where it was nice and cool. Now we have four green speckled frogs. Ribbit, ribbit, can you say that? Ribbit, ribbit. Okay, now let's sing with me, with four green and speckled frogs, yeah? Four green and speckled frogs, sitting on a speckled log, eating the most delicious bugs. Yum, yum. One jumped into the pool, where it was nice and cool. Now we have three green speckled frogs. Ribbit, ribbit. Three green and speckled frogs, sitting on a speckled log, eating the most delicious bugs. Yum, yum. One jumped into the pool, where it was nice and cool. Now we have two green speckled frogs. Ribbit, ribbit! Two green and speckled frogs, sitting on a speckled log, eating the most delicious bugs. Yum, yum! One jumped into the pool, where it was nice and cool. Now we have one green speckled frog. Ribbit, ribbit! One green and speckled frog, sitting on a speckled log, eating the most delicious bugs. Yum, yum. He jumped into the pool, where it was nice and cool. Now we have no green speckled frogs. Ribbit, ribbit. See you next time. Bye-bye.